In this video, complete a watercolor sketch and look at how to paint an eye. We'll layer light values to dark values, let the watercolor paint do the work, and most importantly, we'll be patient, allowing enough time for layers to dry. I'll be using several different brushes for this demonstration, both sable and nylon brushes, and I'll be using my Winsor & Newton Field watercolor set. First, I'll wetten the number 6 sable brush here, and I'm going to use a mixture of yellow ochre and Winsor red and create a very light wash over the entire area of skin tone. We're just going to spread the paint evenly while it's still very wet and very transparent. Next, I'll use a mixture of the same colors, yellow ochre and Winsor red, with a little bit more of the red mixed in, and then we're just going to touch areas while it's still slightly wet on the surface. This technique is known as wet on wet, and it will allow the paint to spread out and move based on how the water will move on the surface. So I'm just touching the surface very gently and allowing those colors to bleed into one another. What we're doing here is we're establishing some undertones that will show through in the final painting. We want to be careful that we don't get too dark with our values here at the start. Progressively throughout the painting, we're going to develop the darker values. After we have allowed a bit of time for this to dry, we're going to go back with the same mixture of colors, just this time with a little bit more of the yellow ochre. And we'll just softly and gently pull that color around into different locations. Here's a quick look at the palette that I'm working from. We're going to pull a little bit of burnt umber into that color, which is a darker brown color, and we're going to add that while the surface is still slightly wet. Again, this is a very transparent wash that we're applying, and we're using a lot of water here. Allow that water to just move on the surface when you apply the color. That's what's going to give the final painting that watercolor feel that is so attractive. Now a little bit of purple is mixed up, and I'm just using ultramarine and Winsor red to create this purple color. There's still a bit of burnt umber on the palette as well, so that mixes in nicely. So in this crease area above the eye, we're going to progressively be darkening this area throughout the painting. So again, we're just establishing some of the undertones of color that will show through. While we have that purple on our brush, we'll move it into a couple of other areas, and then we can also start to work on the whites of the eye, which actually aren't white at all. And in this case, I'm just using a very, very light wash of ultramarine. And maybe we'll add just a bit more of the ultramarine to that wetted area so that it can move around a bit. Now with a little bit of the burnt umber, we're going to create a little bit of a shadow underneath the eye. Again, with each wash, the colors that we've added underneath are going to show through, making the color have a little bit more depth. We'll also pull that burnt umber up into the crease above the eye. Next, using a mixture of sap green and ultramarine, we'll establish the base tone for the iris portion of the eye. Here again, a transparent wash is applied and moved around on the surface. While this application is allowed to dry, we'll turn our focus to the tear duct. And the color that's mixed for the tear duct is a mixture of crimson. There's a bit of burnt umber in the mixture, as well as a little bit of yellow ochre. And a very light wash here again is applied, and it appears dark right now, but as it dries, it'll slowly get lighter. We'll also pull this color around to a couple of other locations around the eye. Now that our iris portion has had some time to dry, we'll apply our initial application to the pupil. This is a mixture between the burnt umber and the ultramarine to create a more natural black. The color black is actually not used at all in this painting. We'll use that same mixture of burnt umber and ultramarine with just a little bit more ultramarine mixed in to start to establish some of the tones around the outside portion of the iris. Sap green is used closer to the area of the pupil since this iris is blue around the edges and progressively gets more green closer to the center. Now using a nylon brush while this area is still partially wet, I'm going to pull out a few lines extending out from the pupil portion of the eye. We'll go back to the crease above the eye now with a bit more burnt umber. The nylon brush here gives me a bit more control, so as we progress in the painting, we start to add details. I'll switch brushes according to what the desired effect is. In this case, I'm wanting to get more precise with my marks, so I switched over to a smaller round nylon brush. We'll go back to the pupil again with that mixture of ultramarine and burnt umber and darken it up a bit. And we'll put another application of that color around the edges of the iris as well, with just a bit more of the ultramarine dominating the mixture. There are a few eyelashes that are reflected in the eye, so a few of those lines are the manifestation of that reflection. The outside portions of the iris are relatively dark in value, so at this stage in the painting, we can start to push those values so that they're a little bit closer to what is observed. We can also go back to the sap green area that's closer to the pupil and develop that area as well. And with each mark, I'm pulling it outward from the center portion of the eye. This will help to create the pattern that's visible in the eye. We'll continue to work those colors and values, progressively getting darker with them. We'll progressively add darker layers of color over the top of what we already have on the surface. Here, a bit more shadow from those eyelashes is added, and we're going to use a bit of that ultramarine to create a little bit more of a shadow on the eyeball that's created from the upper eyelid. We'll pull that color into other portions of the painting as well, including the tear duct. And since our crease above the eye has allowed some time to dry, we can go back again with a darker application of burnt umber. And this mixture, of course, still has a little bit of that ultramarine mixed in. We'll use that natural black mixture again to darken up underneath the eyelid to add a few details to the skin portion under the eye. And with a bit of burnt umber and crimson, we'll develop the tear duct a bit further, and we'll use that wash underneath the eye on the bottom portion of the lid. We'll continue to darken up the values, especially underneath the upper eyelid. And around the edges of the eye where the optical cavity recesses back into the head. A little bit of purple is mixed with burnt umber to create that shadow that happens on the eyelid. And we'll pull that color down underneath the eye as well. We can continue to darken up the recess, this time with a bit of burnt umber. And again, we'll revisit the shadow on the iris portion of the eye and darken up some of the values around it. Our ultimate goal here is to have a full range of value in the painting. This means that we're going to have the dark darks, the light lights, and all the values in between. This is why it's important to push the darker values. Now, with a bit of water added to the brush, I'm just going to go around the edges of the pupil and allow that color to bleed out a little bit, making it a bit more natural and have a little bit less of a hard line. With a bit of ultramarine, I'm going to create a little bit of shadow that happens in the white portion of the eyes, again from the eyelashes that we'll paint in just a second, but these shadows kind of come down over the top of portions of the eye. We'll also darken up the bottom portion of the iris. Now, to add a bit of realism to the painting, we're going to add some imperfections to the skin. I'm going to use a mixture of yellow ochre with a little bit of burnt umber to create that color and just touch a few areas. Then in the highlight portion of the eye, there is a bit of blue. So again, with the ultramarine, we'll add that blue in those locations. Now at this point, we're ready to tackle the eyelashes, and we're just going to create check marks that kind of go down and back up, kind of a smooth rolling pull out from the upper portion of the eyelid. And we're going to use a mixture again of ultramarine and burnt umber to create that natural black. We're going to use the paint a little bit more full-bodied here, so there's less water in the brush. The trick is to create a mixture so that there's enough paint on the brush to create a strong mark, but enough water so that it's easy to pull out and create a line. For the eyelashes on the bottom portion of the eye, we're going to pull it up and out and then downward. So it's almost like an inverse curved check mark. The more irregular you can make these lines, the more natural the eyelashes will appear. Now we're ready to tackle the eyebrow. Again, we're going to use a mixture of burnt umber with a bit of ultramarine to darken the value. And we're just going to pull lines outward just as the hair would grow out from the forehead. We want to create a variety of different marks here as well, and we want to allow some of the skin to show through the marks that we create. Then we'll go back with a darker application. We want to have some variety in this area, variety in value anyway, and that's going to help create the illusion of texture. And we'll go back to that crease above the eye as well and darken it up. We can also do a little bit more additional work to the eyelashes here. I'm just going to thicken up the color a bit further. And then the last touch is to add highlights. I'm using opaque gouache here, which is a form of watercolor, but it's opaque watercolor. And I'm using pure white, heavily loaded, and I'm just going to touch a couple areas where the light is hitting the surface in a strong manner. This will help create the illusion of reflection and make the eye look a bit more wet. And that completes our watercolor sketch. I hope you found this video to be helpful. If you enjoyed this video and you're ready to learn more, why not check out 4 video courses, live instruction, and over 6,000 minutes of art instruction, which include ebooks, live lessons, lesson plans, and more. Just click on the button to learn more now.